From one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Carolina Panthers and the Kansas City Chiefs. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here on first down. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. Oh, wide open, complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A gain of 37.
First down.
We had an idea that they might come out and challenge the secondary, but I don't know if we thought it'd be right out of the gate on the very first play of the game. But they did so successfully, they've got to feel good about how things have started.
And some space to move right away as he's all the way up to the 30. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Brings up second.
If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
On second down, a run with Dobbins. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
Tackle made at the
16. How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid gain.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Call it a gain of 3, and that'll bring up a third down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
Mayfield on play action. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Deontay Johnson, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Panthers take it right down and score on the opening drive. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible? Or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And Hardman going to go ahead and sit on this one as it'll come out to the 25. First and 10, here's Murray. He's got his man, it's Andrews. Yeah, he's gonna get this deep on a Carolina side of the field. An outstanding pickup there for the Chiefs. 65 yards.
First and 10 at the 10-yard line.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. They go play action here on first down. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Hunter Henry, but it'll be second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Throwing is Murray on 3rd down. That's complete right around the 8. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. He did his best to just get 4 out of that, but not enough. And now 4th down. The kick by Lutz is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only 3, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
Following the main field goal, Lutz to kick it away.
The Panthers take over 1st and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for 4 quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade 6s for 3s, things are going to work out in your favor.
The throw right side is complete here on the first play of the drive. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19.
First down.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Play fake. Mayfield. Being chased out left. He's going to take off with it. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
A first down throw for Mayfield. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ron Thornhill. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Oh, man, Brandon, not a real good throw that time. It looked like he tried to put a little too much air under this one, and it turned into a floater. And defensively, this is a dream. He could have fair caught that one. That was way too easy.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on 2nd and 13. From the gun, Murray going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. Room here to run. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. Unfortunately for him, if last week was any indication, we knew a pick was coming at some point. Last week it was interception after interception, and here we go again.
We actually quit counting last week at a certain point because I thought I was going to run out of fingers, all right, because I'm not all that skilled as a mathematician. But you're right. It felt like a matter of time, and you got to think the guys on defense, they couldn't wait for this opportunity after what they saw on tape.
6 yard pickup.
4 yards to go on second down from the 7. Now a handoff for Dobbins. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. J.K. Dobbins. Touchdown number 15 of the year. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there, and each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Ball at the 23, second and 8.
Hey, Mike's 42, Mike's 42.
Out of the gun, here's Murray. Oh, he's trying for Smith-Schuster, but it's intercepted. Kevin King with a pick, and his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Following the interception, Mayfield. His throw caught at about the 5. And he's finally taken down, and it's a big gain there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. After one, a 14-3 ball game.
The score, Panthers 14, Chiefs 3.
They'll run with Dobbins. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Only a yard that time, second and goal.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown, you're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
They'll try to run with Dobbins. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. J.K. Dobbins, his second TD of the game and 16th on the season. And the Panthers add on to their lead. And it's 21-3.
Is good. Makes the score Panthers 21, Chiefs 3.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. It's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is one. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got a...
It got his man complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
Still all sorts of time left in this game, and you'd like to be able to say, take it one play at a time. But the truth is, they're probably going to have to hit on a few big plays in the passing game to close this gap, and that's a good start right there.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. Now they need 15 yards on this series after the delay of game. First and 15.
Let's go, defense.
Following the penalty, it's Williams. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Mike Ford in on the tackle. You don't see that a ton, do you, with a cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle?
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball has moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Well played.
59, Mike. On second and 15 now, Murray. And that'll be incomplete. Murray took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well, incomplete.
Murray with a third and long. Oh, they've intercepted Murray for the third time. Shaquille Griffin with a pick, and they will take over at the 26-yard line.
They'll take over.
You hear me laughing, partner, and I'm not laughing at the situation, but sometimes you just get yourself into a rut. It's hard to shake yourself out of it.
On first and 10, Mayfield. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. Greg Olsen was the intended target. But it's going to be second down. Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Mayfield looks to throw. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a Carolina first down on a gain of 16.
A gain of
the goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Mayfield. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
A gain of 9 brings up second and 1 at the Chiefs 49-yard line.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. Mayfield with it once more. That's complete to his running back, J.K. Dobbins. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
You're crediting your defense.
Got to credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 24-yard line. A pickup of 27, and they pick up the first down in the process. So now first and 10 in Chiefs' territory at the 24. And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. That will go as a pickup of 7 on the 7th play of the drive.
It's a game. Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
He's got it for a Panther touchdown. J.J. Arcega-Whiteside, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead.
I know a lot of people look at these games and think, all right, this thing's done. Let's have some sportsmanship. Let's not try and score. You should never do that in the NFL. I've seen big leads blown, and teams that look like they had a victory, all of a sudden we're going home with a loss.
Extra point by Moore, up and good. And the route is on here in this first half.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And with 3 interceptions thrown already, we'll see, do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
A big play on the catch and run, covering 34 yards.
41-yard line.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Now Murray. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Miles Garrett in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Shotgun now for Murray. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Hit as he throws there, incomplete. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get to third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. They're going for it. Hits Murray. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. On fourth down, that turned out like a punt. Maybe he was better defensively there just to knock it down.
And you know they go over those situations. All right, fourth down, where's the ball? Where would we get the ball? But instinct takes over, and when it's in the air, they just go and get it. So it's hard to get on him for intercepting it, but the smart play would have been what you suggested. Knock it down and take over in a deeper position. He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
On second down, Dobbins. And once again, not much running room, if any at all. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
No gain on the play, and it's third down.
And now Mayfield on the bootleg. Open man has got one. It's complete. And he takes this just about a yard shy of the 20. The Panthers have the first. It's a gain of 12. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now a man open down the middle of the field and way up past the 35 before he's taken down. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
Gain of 20. First down.
And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Final play of the half, Mayfield looking down. That's caught inside the 20. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
And they extend their lead, a little added cushion into the lockers. What a way to finish.
Tremendous way. That's momentum that they carry in with them. Can they convert it and bring it back out to start the third quarter?
And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Marr now to kick this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Mike is 59. Mike the 59.
Go, go, go. Mike, Mike.
Murray now on first down. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Bud Dupree. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. That one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that.
Touchdown, Carolina! Chris Godwin with his second touchdown of the game, number seven on the year. And thanks to the interception, the Panthers offense cashes in with six. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter.
Thanks to score, Panthers 42, Chiefs 3.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, Just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And incomplete on the deep ball. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch. They tried to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
Murray looks to throw again, second and 10. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Another attempt, another incompletion. And when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points. And the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
To throw on third down, Murray. And that is incomplete.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. They do go for it. It's Murray. The open man is Shark. It's complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Not often do fourth down conversions result in 23 yards, but that's the case here. First down. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. From the gun, Murray. Well, this is caught by Williams. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. 22 yards there, a first down.
Now what we're seeing, this is much better from this offense because so far in this game, no touchdown to this point. And what's usually a direct correlation? Very few explosive plays. That's been their issue. Not able to make that big shot downfield or break one off, but a nice game there for a first down.
Throwing on first down is Murray. That's complete to DeAndre Swift out of the backfield. This will be a short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
To throw again on second down. Murray looking left side. Andrews with it complete. And this will be a gain of six when it's all said and done. Down to the 15 from the 21.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. Got what he needed for the first down with a gain of two. And they gave themselves options there on the third down play and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
He's going to get four out of this as he's down to the 10-yard line. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
To throw on second and six. Murray, this will be caught at about the five. And he'll be brought down here at the three-yard line. He's now just 3 yards shy of 197 yards receiving on the contest and a first down. They'll run with Swift, and this will result in him losing yardage back to the three. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
I think this running game, or should I say lack of one, is making this defense look better than what they really are.
So they're backed up to the three-yard line, second and goal. To throw is Murray. He's got it. Touchdown, Chiefs. Mark Andrews, his second touchdown on the season. And it may only be for pride now, but the Chiefs get a bit closer.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. He finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Still well in control of this ball game despite giving up that touchdown a moment ago. Looking deep downfield. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
The good old cover three defense, partner. When you start playing football as a safety, that's the first thing you're taught. Middle of the field, be as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, and break on the football when it's thrown, and pick it off, just as we saw there.
Yeah, nice yardage right off the bat here as he's up to about the 24-yard line.
Ball carrier.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
The second down attempt there knocked down as it leaves the cornerback's hand, and it's incomplete.
In any event, it happened pretty quickly. I'm not sure he made the right decision on that one. I think if he had it to do over again, he would have found a different target downfield. But he made his decision, and that one's incomplete.
And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And some room to roam now. And he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line.
By the Panthers.
But to be frank, CeeDee, this is getting tough to watch. I mean, you feel for him, but six interceptions, that's at a whole new level. It's not a good level.
It makes it tougher and tougher to come up with ways to try and support him. But you have to as a team because you can't just throw your quarterback aside. You're going to need him later on. But it reminds me of a time that a former defense coordinator of mine told me he was in a game where his quarterback threw seven interceptions. So after the 6-1, one of the defensive players went to the quarterback and said, here's what you do. Throw the ball to the other team, and let's see if our receivers can pick it off and turn it into a completion.
That's just mean. I don't know that I'd go down there and say that to him right now. Probably pretty fragile. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he's going to get this inside the 30. A gain of 13. It's a first down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
First down, Mayfield. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. We're back now in KC. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair.
Watch the screen! Pass! Check, check. Watch 54. Watch 54.
Watch the run. Watch the run.
Alert, alert. Alert, alert.
Hey, watch that. Watch that. Check, Mike. Check.
And again, it's Mayfield. Steps away. Touchdown, Carolina.
They seemingly just continue to score at will, and as great as it's been for the offense, you got to feel for that defense down there.
I love how you use the word will, because both teams came into the game with the will to win, but one team has obviously imposed its will on the other and broken them, because what we're seeing right now, wow, that's a defense that's in tatters after what they faced in this ball game.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And just looking ahead, it would appear that that bye week is coming at the right time. They'll have 2 weeks to chew on this one, though probably not one that they want to chew on. A poor performance. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way down to the 35. Play there for KC, and even 40 yards. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. Murray gonna throw. Pressure comes in, he's brought down, it's a Panther sack. Myles Garrett, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done.
Oh, yeah, I'm coming. 58 for Mike, 58.
58. Murray now to throw. And my goodness, another interception. Julian Love picks it. Pass the twat, and he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers.
Brett Maher on for the extra.
Defensively, they've had their way in this one. That pick six makes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what do you do when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You ready to go to the bench and hang out? He said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. Might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Meticulous repair, special force in nature. I don't want to seem absurd, but that boy's a gangster.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. It's now appearing that this losing streak is going to continue. You know, the coaching staff was confident that this was going to be the game to stem the tide, but that just has not been the case. Murray trying again after the pick six. It's complete to Williams. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
At the 26.
Last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26.
It's our time. Mike Fox.
Hit from behind, and he's going to be driven down.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury.
Throwing is Murray on third down. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Now Murray's got to have this one. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And now here is another interception. Kevin King with a pick. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
Well, partner, I got to tell you, I'm trying to think of something positive to say for this offense, but I'd have to be a spin doctor for that one. This has been a tough performance to watch.
And I think it's hard at this point to actually identify what's really gone wrong. I guess the catch-all is everything. Doesn't sound like real sharp analysis, but I don't have much else for you.
And the scoreboard just lopsided, and it's been ugly from the get-go.
From the 36, Mayfield. They set up the screen for Dobbins. So the screen good for only two. Now it's third down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
He's going
to
air. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Carolina. J.J. Arcega-Whiteside with his second touchdown of the game, number seven on the year, as his guys continue to pour it on. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game, defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching, and he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers.
Looking to throw again on second down. Murray. And some room to maneuver. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
And oh, it's no good on the PAT, so they can't add on here. And our score is going to stay right where it is. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
He was brought down
2 yards on the pick up there. It'll be second and eight.
A gain of two brings up second and eight at the 27-yard line.
59, Mike. 59, Mike. Check, check.
Out of the gun, here's Murray. Going top shelf for Smith's shoot. He's got a man, complete. And they finally do get him, but not before he reaches the 27. An outstanding pickup there for the Chiefs. 45 yards. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Looking for the end zone and nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Second and 10 now from the 27. Throwing again. Murray. On the slant, this is Chark. And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late. But he does get in for six.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man.
That's a whole lot of points still to be down. But congratulations, they're still fighting, and they scored another touchdown.
My old high school coach used to say, Charles, he said, sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, and sometimes you wish you never would show up.
Could have saved the gas money, the hotel, what have you, huh?
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
At their own 26-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. On second down now, Dobbins. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
Jesse Bates.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
First down, Carolina.
Right back to Dobbins on first. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in quarter number four.
It's second and eight.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Well, the lead late in the fourth, but Mayfield's going to throw it. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Now, this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
Panthers 76, Chiefs 17.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today, coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it because
you're not going to want that feeling.
No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
Murray again, second and 10. And Murray in trouble here, and down he goes. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. Murray with a third and long. That one complete. He finds Sharp. And he's not going to sniff the first down here. He stopped at the 25. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Staying put for now. They'll go for it on fourth down. Murray sets to throw on fourth. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept.